I'm Tiffany. I'm a director on the business development team at AppLovin. I recently moved over from MoPub to join the AppLovin team, and I'm here to help you move over your app business as well. The team has been really busy building lots of new features, many of which you're used to from MoPub, including native ads and FireOS support, custom networks, and most importantly, the AppLovin Exchange, which is used to be the MoPub marketplace and now is exclusive to Max Mediation. There is also an ad unit import tool to help you seamlessly auto-migrate your waterfall and network settings to Max from MoPub. And in today's video, I'll be walking you through those steps to migrate and move over to Max and accelerate your revenue growth. We have a companion checklist for the video that is linked below that can be used as a reference during this process. So let's get started. Okay, the first step to migrating your app business over to Max is to visit dash.applovin.com. This is the sign up page, and to sign up an account is click that link, and it will take you to a sign up form that you can fill out, and then you create an account, and then there's a two-factor authorization where, you know, we'll email you or text you a code to your cell phone, and then you'll be able to get into your account. Please keep in mind that the MoPub platform is shutting down on March 31st. That means that there will be no more ads coming from MoPub at that time, and any revenue that's generated on MoPub Marketplace through March 31st will be paid on your normal payment schedule from the MoPub team. Those payment details will not transfer over to AppLovin, so it's important after you create your account to go and re-enter your payment information onto Max. So the first step in migrating your MoPub waterfalls over to Max is to create an app and an ad unit. So we're on the Max UI, and you'll want to make sure that you're actually clicked onto Max and then go to ad units, and this is how you get to this page. To create an ad unit, you just click create an ad unit, and then you just name it. You pick the desired platform. You want to grab the store URL. So right now, this is the MoPub sample app that I'm registering with Max. Where did it go? And then we're going to drop it in here. So numerical iTunes ID. So when you drop in the whole URL, you just kind of want to lose everything except for the ID. You see that the app populates. If your app does not populate, do not worry. There is a manual option to add your app, which will pop up if your app does not show. The next step is to pick your ad format. In this case, it's rewarded. And then we want to go import existing ad unit ID. So what we're going to do is to migrate your waterfall configurations and your networks from MoPub. This is the button that's going to allow that to happen. So we're going to go import existing ad unit ID. I already have it populated here, but for you to be able to find it on MoPub, it's just your publisher management API key, which you can grab from here. So going back to Max, it's here. We're gonna go next. It's populating. And all my networks and network settings that I had set up in MoPub are now present in the Max UI. So we'll just take a quick look. Here's my MoPub sample app, sample rewarded video, and then here goes all my networks. We have Facebook, Advanced Bidding, Marketplace, Chart Boost, and a Facebook mediated line. So if we pop on over back to Max, we can see that we have AppLovin and the AppLovin network and the AppLovin exchange, which used to be known as Marketplace, are already turned on for you by default, so there's nothing to do there. We have Meta, formerly known as Facebook, that's populated over as a bidding network. And then here under other networks, we have our mediated networks. We have AdMob and ChartBoost. And all the details have been ported over from MoPub. I'm going to go ahead and turn off AdMob since I don't have my Google App ID. And then we're going to save. But before I save, if there's any networks that you want to set up within Max, you see all the options here. We have, I think, over 20 plus SDK networks that you can work with. And if there's any networks here that you want to work with that aren't, any networks that you want to work with that are not present here, you can set them up as a custom network. You can adjust your frequency capping or set your bid floor. At this point, a bid floor is just any bidding networks that come in under the floor that you set here won't be considered for the ad request. And you can also country target the bid floor. And your ad units save, and it's now present here on the ad units page of the Max UI. It is recommended on the MoPub side, you may be used to creating multiple ad units per ad format, maybe for caching purposes, maybe because you needed to pull reporting for each placement within your app. There's no need to do that here with Max. It's recommended that you only use one ad unit for easier onboarding, for optimized caching. And also, if you do want to pull more detailed metrics on the placements within your app, there is a ad placements feature where you can do that differentiator there within the SDK. So we'll link to the instructions below, but essentially within the SDK, you can call out this rewarded video is for between levels, or this rewarded video is like at the end of the game. And then that data will pull into Max reporting. So that's a little bit about the waterfall. One thing that we also need to cover is actually like when you set up your networks within, within Max and in your waterfall, especially for your mediated networks, we'll just kind of show you what I mean. You can manually enter your CPM here. So similar to MoPub, it's a manual CPM. It should reflect the actual CPM that you're receiving from the network. It's really hard to stay on top of this, right? Because the CPM tends to fluctuate. This is like something that you would have to go in daily to make sure that it's, aligned with the network. So to make it easier on yourself, you can just go to the networks tab. So Chart Boost was our mediated network. We want to make sure that we connect our network. So you would just log in. You would just enter the credentials that you log into your Chart Boost account with here and enable auto CPM. And then you will be able to have that CPM automatically update. You want to make sure that you're connecting all your networks, your bidding networks and your mediated networks. So this way the two platforms are talking to each other and you're able to like centrally manage and see data all in one place within the Max platform. After you've connected your networks, there is a network comparison report. I won't be able to run it because I have no data in my account, but if we switch over to our test account, we can see here, we'll just pull it for the last 7 days. And wait, networks. In the last 7 days, you can actually see like the revenue that you're receiving from these networks, that what Max is recording, what the network is recording, and the revenue delta between the two, the revenue delta between the actual, between the revenues, and then the delta between the CPMs. You'll want to make sure that you're not higher than, a couple of percentage points for the CPM. If you are, then please reach out to us and we'll help you get to the bottom of what's going on there. All right, now that we've walked through how to migrate your waterfalls over from MoPub to Max, we're going to talk a little bit about the Max waterfall, how it works, and some best practices. So the first step is to come to the left nav, click Max, then click Ad Unit. You're going to want to click your Ad Unit, so sample rewarded video. And then here is the waterfall that we've set up. It's very basic. We have the AppLovin network, the AppLovin exchange, which again are turned on by default, and all the other networks that that are available as bidders within Max. Down here for other networks are our mediated networks. So from the MoPub side, we've ported over Chart Boost and our details there. And that's all we have, but there's an option to do custom networks if you want to set those up, or for private marketplace deals, and all of that jazz. So what we're going to do is, if you ever wanted to visualize your waterfall a little bit better, you can click these three dots here, say preview waterfall. And so when an ad request hits, this essentially is what will happen. An ad request hits this ad unit and everything competes as one. So you have your AppLovin exchange and you have the AppLovin network, and then we have Chart Boost. So for example, if an ad request comes in from the United States, AppLovin, exchange may bid $5, and it would, and if it had fill, it would win the impression because, you know, Chart Boost is set at 5 cents, and we'll say that the AppLovin network came in lower. So in this example, the AppLovin exchange would win the impression. And it's as simple as that. The majority of publishers, as I say, see success on Max as they did with MoPub by running as many networks as they can that have fill in their like desired formats and then where they have the greatest numbers of users, right? So at a minimum, we would say start with working with 4 to 6 networks. So if you had a small setup, a simple setup at MoPub, this is a great time to optimize your waterfall and drive more revenue. You can pick from any of these networks here and get them set up. If you ever need help with an introduction to these networks, just contact us and we're happy to help. We're also happy to help you pick the right networks for you and the right way to set up your waterfall. So you don't have to do this alone. You can definitely reach out to us and we're happy to help. Another option that's available to you, especially on iOS specifically, is that if you wanted to create a new waterfall, this is called waterfall segmentation, you can create one. The biggest use case is creating one for your non-IDFA users. So basically the users who are on iOS 14 or above and don't want to pass their device ID. This is non-IDFA users. These users are a little less valuable to buyers because we don't have the information to send like targeted ads. So if you wanted to create a waterfall where you have the, you know, we're targeting the specific users and have have lower CPMs or lower bid floors for them, you can do that option. You can just go non-IDFA users. It will copy over your waterfall details. So now we have our default waterfall for all our, you know, actual IDFA users, and we have one for non-IDFA users. And in here, you can kind of go in and readjust your, you know, your CPMs or bid floors or anything that you need. And then the last part of managing your waterfall is a really cool feature is whenever you start working with a network and you just want to kind of test drive the network or test drive a new waterfall configuration or test drive new pricing, that you use our A/B test feature. You can roll it out to a percentage of your users. We default to 50%, but you can change that percentage if you want. Let's actually do that. Let's create an A/B test. And so you can say, I want to create a new waterfall and I want 50% of my users to be able to experience it. So you go create A/B test. And so now we have the test waterfall for either the non-DFA users, for the non-IDFA users. You can also create an A/B test for your default waterfall as well, if you wanted. After we've created our A/B test waterfall, we hit save. Oh, first we gotta name it, sorry. Now it's saving. We'll go back into this. When you run your A/B test for a week or so and you start to see the results, if the results look great, if you're seeing lifts in your ARPDAU or your CPMs or your revenue, you can promote the test and roll the test waterfall out to 100% of your users, and now this becomes your standard waterfall. If the test isn't working the way that you had hoped, then you can either end the test or deprecate the test. That's the same thing. It will just end the test, and then 100% of your users will get the previous waterfall, the control waterfall. So we'll say deprecate test and end and save. Now that we've learned how our waterfall works and we've connected our networks and we've set our waterfall up and everything looks good, you should start with the technical side of the migration process, which is integrating the Max SDK. When you migrate over to Max and you integrate the Max SDK, you will need to prepare for an app update. Make sure that you're grabbing the latest SDK from us. You can find it on our documentation site. You can just find iOS, Android, Adobe, whichever platform that you're developing for. And you can go to the integration section and grab the SDK. We've linked the SDK to the bottom of the screen also to make things a little easier for you. Prior to launching Max, you'll want to make sure that you remove the MoPub SDK. If you don't, you might experience some technical issues down the line. So it's just best to remove the MoPub SDK before you launch. To uninstall the MoPub SDK, you'll just want to reverse the steps that were taken to integrate the SDK, including removing all the MoPub SDK API calls made within the application code. Then release the new app version using Max as the new mediation solution. So we've talked about integration. Before you even push anything live, though, you're going to want to make sure that your Max integration is good and it's tested and everything is working as expected. You're requesting and getting an ad return from not only AppLovin, but from your network partners. And to do this, we have lots of tools for you to use. One of the most important ones will be your mediation debugger. It will confirm that you have successfully completed your Max integration. And sorry, let me go to the integration debugger. So we're here to get started with Max, mediation debugger. And this is the documentation to walk you through it. So as I said, it will help you confirm that you have successfully completed your Max and network integration correctly. It allows you to test using both test ads and live ads. It will generate a copy of the integration checklist to share with us to review before you launch, which I highly recommend that you do. And to see an example of how the integration and the debugger process works for Unity, you can also click the link below for a video. These steps that we've walked through today will help you migrate your business over from MoPub to Max very quick, very efficiently, and help you start to kickstart your revenue growth on a Max mediation platform. Just reminding you again that MoPub shuts down on March 31st, so you're going to want to make sure that if you haven't already started the migration process, that you do so. You want to make sure that you're giving yourself enough time to integrate and to test and allow your users to update so you don't see any significant revenue impact. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions, and we look forward to monetizing with you. Thanks.